friends. My name is Leander, and I hope you're having a great day so far. Today, we'll be playing a little game, and the game is called Deckscape, the test. Maybe you will have already noticed that this game is in German, because so am I when I'm not with you. But don't worry, I thought about how or even if I can play this game with you. But then I remembered that some of the ASMR artists that I personally enjoy have done videos which were partly in their native language, and I enjoyed hearing that, so I thought, why not do the same? So we will play this game. I will read the text to you in German, and then I'll translate it into English so you can follow along. So let's have a look what's inside. This is a card game with, I believe, 60 cards. I haven't played it yet, but I had a look at the first few cards to see if it was even a good idea to play this game on video. And I think it is. So the first few cards are mainly explanation of how to play the game, and I'll read the most important facts for you. Attention! Schaut euch die Karten in diesem Stapel nicht an und mischt sie nicht. Die Karten sind von 1 bis 60 nummeriert. Die Kartennummer steht jeweils in der oberen linken Ecke. Wenn die Kartenreihenfolge verändert wurde, bittet jemand, der nicht mitspielt, sie von 1 bis 60 zu sortieren. Attention! Don't look at the cards in the stack and don't mix them. The cards are numbered from 1 to 60. Card number is in the top left corner. If they're not sorted yet, ask someone else to sort them for you. Now, this is just general information about how to play the game. It says here it will take us 60 minutes, roughly. So maybe this will be a two-part video. We'll see. This is just more explanation about how escape rooms work in general. And this card is showing us where we are in the lab of Dr. Thyme. Let's have a look. So we have an office with a cupboard with a keep out sign and some skull and crossbones. We have a desk over here, a desk over here, and here we have some lab equipment on the side, and here we have a pin board, some notes, and here we have a blackboard with some formulas. Up at the top there's a clock saying 14:50, so 2:50 in the afternoon. and everything else, I don't know, looks more or less normal to me. We'll see. So we are supposed to put this card down on the table where we can always see it. Next. Dr. Time begrüßt euch. Willkommen in meinem Labor. Ihr wurdet unter meinen besten Studenten für ein besonderes Projekt ausgewählt. Ich werde eure Fähigkeiten testen und wenn ihr besteht, bekommt ihr die einmalige Chance, mir bei meiner neuesten und größten Erfindung zu helfen. Verschwendet keine Zeit und arbeitet zusammen, oder ihr werdet diesen Test nicht bestehen. Dark Thyme is greeting you. Welcome to my lab. You have been chosen from my best students for a special project. I will test your skills, and if you pass, you will get the once-in-a-lifetime chance to help me with my newest and greatest invention. Don't waste time and work together, or you will not pass this test. So this card is explaining that there are two types of cards. There are Rätsel und Gegenstände, so puzzles and objects. Objects can be used several times, but if we try to solve a puzzle without having the necessary object for it, we will be punished. And we only have one chance to solve each puzzle. If we answer wrong, that counts as a mistake. Der Doc spricht weiter. Jetzt werde ich euch alles erklären. Fasst in der Zwischenzeit nichts in diesem Raum an. Es könnte gefährlich sein. Und während er das sagt, drückt er geistesabwesend einen schwarzen Knopf. Ring! Plötzlich ertönt ein lauter Alarm. Schwere Gitter verschließen alle Ausgänge. Das Labor ist abgeriegelt. Die Lichter gehen aus und das Letzte, was ihr seht, ist, wie Doc Thyme schreiend durch eine Falltür unter seinen Füßen fällt. Oops. Now I will explain everything to you. In the meantime, don't touch anything in this room. It could be dangerous. And while he says that, he absentmindedly pushes a button. Ring. A black button. Suddenly, a loud alarm rings. Heavy gates are blocking all exits. The laboratory is locked off. The lights are turning off, and the last thing that you see is how Dark Thyme is falling through a trapdoor and is screaming, "Whoops!" Well, clumsy professor. Now, here's our first puzzle. Ihr befindet euch in der Dunkelheit eines abgeriegelten Labors, das voll von geheimnisvollen Erfindungen ist. Ist Doctheim in Gefahr? Oder ist das alles Teil des Tests? Das Einzige, was ihr sehen könnt, sind drei Lichtschalter, die an der Wand leuchten. Die nächste Karte ist ein Rätsel. Seid ihr bereit für das Spiel? Lest die nächste Karte sorgfältig, findet gemeinsam eine Lösung, dreht die Karte um und überprüft die Lösung. You find yourself in the darkness of a locked-off laboratory that is full of mysterious inventions. Is Doctheim in danger, or is this all a test? The only thing that you can see are three light switches that are glowing on the wall. The next card is a puzzle. Are you ready for the game? Read the next card carefully. Find a solution together. And turn the card over to check your solution. An der Wand befinden sich eine farbige Zeichnung und drei Knöpfe. Ein blauer, ein violetter und ein roter. Drückt den Knopf, der alle drei Lichter anschaltet. On the wall, there is a colorful drawing and three buttons. A blue one, a violet one and a red one. Push the button that is turning on all three lights at the same time. So, you can have a closer look at the card. And we can think about how we should solve this puzzle. I think this is fairly easy. We can see here that blue light and red light are mixing together to form violet light. So, if our task is to push one button to get all three lights activated, then I think it should probably be the violet one. Let's see if we're right. Die Zeichnung erinnert euch daran, dass Violett aus Blau und Rot besteht. Das weist darauf hin, dass das Drücken des violetten Knopfes alle drei Lichter anschaltet. So, yes. The drawing reminds us that violet is made of blue and red. This is a sign that pushing the violet button turns on all three lights. So, yeah, I think this was a pretty easy puzzle to get started. But funnily enough, you can't see it, but maybe you can see when I hold the card like this, I have a violet light next to me, which is comprised of mainly blue and red LEDs, giving violet light. So, yeah, would have been quite embarrassing if I got that one wrong. Let's move on to the next card. Die Lichter gehen an, aber das Labor ist immer noch abgeriegelt und es gibt keine Spur von Doctheim. Auf dem Boden findet ihr einen Gegenstand, das Wertungsblatt. Dreht diese Karte um und schaut euch das Wertungsblatt an. Behaltet es. Es könnte nützlich sein. The lights turn on, but the laboratory is still locked off and there's no sign of Doctheim. On the ground you find an object. The scoring sheet, I think. this card around and look at the scoring sheet. Keep it. It could be useful. Wenn ihr dazu aufgefordert werdet, tragt ihr die Uhrzeit hier ein. Tragt die Uhrzeit bei Spielende hier ein. Je schneller ihr das Spiel beendet, desto besser ist euer Ergebnis. Jedes Mal, wenn ihr einen Fehler macht, notiert ihr ein X auf dieser Linie. So, when you are asked, put in the time here. When you end the game, put in the time there. The faster you are, the better your result. Every time you make a mistake, make one X on this line. I don't think I'm gonna do that, to be honest, because I'm not playing against the time here. And since I'm shooting a video, I can't play it in real time anyway. Especially not while translating. So, we're gonna keep the card, but put it on the side. Don't think it's gonna be important. Hinweis. Behaltet diese und die nächste Karte. Auf den Rückseiten sind Hinweise zu den Rätseln. Lest sie nur, wenn ihr das Spiel vereinfachen wollt. So, keep this card and the next one. On their backsides there are hints to the puzzles. Only read it when you want to make it easier. I don't want to make it easier yet, but I'm gonna follow the game and put them on the side here. Let's see how far I can get without those guides. Those hints. The test begins. So now we have four decks of yellow, green, red and blue cards, and we are supposed to put them down in front of us. And this is how far I looked at the game before. So, everything from here on out is as new for me as it is for you. So now we're gonna start with the uppermost cards on the yellow deck. The blackboard. Während ihr lest, was auf dieser Tafel steht, erklingt eine Roboterstimme. Drückt X, um fortzufahren. While you are reading what is written on the blackboard, you are hearing a robot voice. Push X to continue. What do we do? Well, let's have a look at the card a bit more closely. Here we have a blackboard on one side, and we have this number pad next to it. And on this number pad, I hope you can see it, there is, in fact, an X symbol, which, well, technically is the times symbol, like in 1 times 2. But since we are asked to press the X, I think that's gonna be the solution. I hope I'm right. So let's find out. Yes, indeed. No math knowledge is required. Just press the X button on the Oh, it's supposed to be a calculator, I see. I thought it was a... like a thing to open a vault or something. Good, so we passed this one. Oh, it was. It was a number pad to open a vault type thing, because now the blackboard is flipping back and we are seeing two compartments that are separated by a glass plane. The voice is saying, "Findet den Knopf mit dem falschen Spiegelbild." Find the button with the wrong mirror image. Okay, so let's look at the card. Well, okay, let's compare. We have a 4 and a 4. They seem to be mirror images, the 1 and the 1 as well. The 5 and the 5. Yeah, I think so. 2 and the 2 seem good, I think. I've got to take down the card a bit, as I can see. The 9 and the 6 seem good. Oh, I mean, the 6... Oh, no, they don't. Look at those two. This one has the open side on the left, and this one has the open side to the right. But just to be sure, let's look at the last two buttons. 8 and 8 look the same. 7 and 7, yeah. Okay. So, unless I'm totally off, I'm gonna push. Or we are gonna push the number 6. Boop. And we are right. We don't get an X for a wrong answer. And we move on. Die Tafel bewegt sich. Als sie das X auf den Taschenrechner drückt. Oh. Well. I'm sorry, guys. It seems that the cards were not in the correct order. Yeah, we did 14 before we did 13. Well, I don't think it's gonna be a problem. Sorry. So, als ihr das X auf dem Taschenrechner drückt, gleitet die Tafel zur Seite. An einer Glasscheibe sind ein paar Notizen geheftet. Dreht diese Karte um und schaut euch die Notizen an. Behaltet sie. Sie könnten nützlich sein. So, when we press the X on the calculator, the blackboard is moving to the side. On a glass plane, there are some notes. Turn this card around, look at the notes, and keep it. The notes could be useful later on. So, I'm going to show those notes to you. You can see them. I'm not sure what is going to be important and what isn't, but what immediately catches my eye is those colorful squares with one of them marked out. The rest, to be honest, seems a bit too complicated for this kind of game. At least I hope it is. Die Fächer öffnen sich. Die Fächer öffnen sich und ihr entdeckt einen Tresor in der Wand. Die Roboterstimme sagt: Drückt auf das Quadrat, auf das die Pfeile zeigen. The panels open and you are seeing a vault in the wall. The robot voice says: Press on the square that arrows are pointing to. Okay, let's look at this. There are a lot of arrows and they are all pointing somewhere. I hope you can see them big enough, they're quite small. And I have to kind of look up a bit awkwardly so I can show them to you while looking at them at the same time. So, what do they mean, the square that the arrows are pointing to? Do they follow some kind of pattern, maybe? Like in a circle or towards the center? I don't see anything obvious. Maybe it's just the white ones with the white background on the black background, but I think I see it. There are four white arrows here, 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 and here. They are all pointing towards this black arrow here, slightly off center to the top left corner. Unless there are several of these, I think that is probably the solution. Let's have a look. These four arrows. No, they're not all pointing the same way. The black ones don't either, those black ones don't, those black ones don't, those white ones don't. Yeah, okay. I think I'm pretty sure about the solution. So, I hope you're with me, and don't think I'm missing something quite obvious, but I'm gonna push the arrow I pointed to. Boop. And turn the card around. And yes, we were right. Oh, and obviously I missed that not just the white arrows were pointing at that square, but the black ones as well. Well, lucky me that I got it right anyway. I think you probably saw that. Well, let's move on anyway. And make sure that we pick the right card next. Yes, 15 now. It's 16. Im Tresor. Ihr drückt auf das Quadrat und der Tresor öffnet sich mit einem Klicken. Es befinden sich keine Wertsachen darin, nur ein Schlüsselbund und ein verschlossener Werkzeugkasten. Dieser Test wird wohl leichter als erwartet. Dreht diese Karte um und schaut euch den Schlüsselbund an. Behaltet ihn, er könnte nützlich sein. In the vault. You push the square and the vault opens with a click. There are no valuables in there. Just a ring of keys and a locked toolbox. This test is going to be easier than expected. Turn the card around and look at the keys. Keep them. They could be useful. So, here we have those keys, and they all have different tooth or teeth configurations. Seems that they all have three rows. Some of them have teeth on both sides of the key, some only on one side. They all have different ends as well. So, let's see if that's gonna matter or not. So I'm gonna put them down on the table to keep them for later. Card number Number 17. Der Werkzeugkasten. Im Tresor ist auch ein stabiler Werkzeugkasten aus Metall. Um ihn öffnen zu können, müsst ihr den richtigen Code eingeben. The Toolbox. In the vault there's also a stable toolbox made of metal. To open it, you must enter the right code. Okay, so we have a code wheel down here with three numbers, three digits. Right now it says 593. And we are supposed to know the digits to put in there. So I think that probably those digits are going to be on the notes somewhere. Let's have a look. So the first thing that catches my eye is this right here. It says 224 divided by 2. So I guess that would mean it would be 112, 112. Those might be the digits, but I'm gonna have a second look. There is something that looks like a timer, but no digits. Those are all letters and symbols. So are these. And I don't think I can get any numbers out of the squares. Just to be sure, let's have a look at the keys again. If there are any numbers hidden here, I mean, could somehow maybe count the number of key of teeth, but I don't think that's going to be the solution. So I hope you're with me, and I'm just gonna enter the 112 into the code wheel. And turn the card around. Oh no, I'm not, am I? I didn't even consider these shapes here. I thought they would be something else, like maybe they have to do with the keys later on, but maybe they are supposed to tell me something. Maybe it's 2, what could this be, 5, maybe 251. Huh. So, what now? I mean, the 2 and the 1 are kind of clear, but not really. But the second digit, if that's a digit, is really out there. Could be a 5, like a digital 5, but there's 2 extra arms, so. Well, I think I'm still gonna go with the 112. Final answer. Oh, okay. So, that was wrong. Um diesen Kasten zu öffnen, braucht ihr die Karte 777 und müsst den richtigen Code eingeben. 237. Wenn ihr die Karte 777 überlappend auf den Werkzeugkasten legt, könnt ihr den Code lesen. 237. Wenn eure Antwort falsch ist, notiert ein X. Wenn ihr die Karte 777 noch nicht habt, notiert ein zweites X und dreht diese Karte um. Habt ihr sie? Geht weiter zur nächsten Karte. Okay, so we made a mistake. To open this toolbox, we need the card 777. And then we have to enter the code 237. If we place the card 777 onto this card, then we can see the right code, 237. So, I think we were supposed to find out or think that, realize that we don't have a solution here. So we should have picked up decks, cards from other decks. Oh yeah, well. If only I could read. I tried to speed up the whole thing a bit for you so that you don't get bored by me reading all the explanations, but if I had read this card, the blue one, it said to turn around the first cards on each deck at the beginning and write down the time, which we are not doing. So, my fault. So, removing all the cards. And now we have more hints, more puzzles. Let's have a look. The green card. Der Schrank. Dieser Schrank ist verschlossen. Findet den passenden Schlüssel, um ihn zu öffnen. The locker. This locker is locked. Find the matching key to open it. Well, we do have a set of keys here, but I'm not sure if we already know which one will fit. Let's have a look at the other cards. Die Schreibtischschublade. Der Schreibtisch hat eine verriegelte Schublade. Drückt auf das richtige Quadrat, um die Verriegelung zu öffnen. Well, I think we do know the solution to this one. It's probably on this card of notes here, but it doesn't seem to be super obvious because the colors don't actually match. We'll have a look at that in a minute. But let's look at the blue card first. Das Bücherregal. Die Uhr an der Wand zeigt die falsche Zeit. Vielleicht ist das ein Hinweis auf eines der Bücher. Aber welches Buch? The bookshelf. The clock on the wall is showing the wrong time. Maybe that's a hint to a book. But which book? Okay. So. Let's look for the key to the cupboard. Let's compare if there are any clues on here that could tell us which key is the correct one. We have the skull and crossbones. I don't see any reference to that. We have the fire warning and the crossbones. Don't see any fire on the key rings either. And we have keep out and crossbones. Don't think that's gonna be anything. And we have the mask with, oh yeah, okay. I think you're gonna see it, or maybe you already saw it long ago before I noticed. The mask has this very obvious, now that I see it, very obvious pattern on the face, and the same pattern is here on this end of the key. So I think, yeah, we're gonna use this key here to open this cupboard. Let's see if we're right. Yes, we were. Great. No X for us. Now we can have a look at this one. So, the colors don't really match the colors on the notes. So what is the way here? Are they inverted? Are they mirrored? Are they negative colors? I'm gonna hold it closer to the camera so you can see as well. I think I see it. I hope you do too. What I find really obvious in this drawing here are those two blue squares here and those two blue squares here. And those are also present here and here. So I think just needs to be turned around, because then the pattern should match. You have red, red, green, green, yellow, red, red, yellow, red, green, green. Yeah, that fits. So, if you have a close look, this square here, this yellow, red square is marked with an X. So, we're gonna press this button. Turn the card around and see if we were right. And yes, we were. Great, so no mistakes there for us. Now let's have a look at the clock. It says 14:50 or 2:50 in the afternoon, and the books read Shaw's, Bell, Jake, Oshie, Hout, Polk, and Dean. Maybe if we look at it this way. Oh yes. Okay. I hope it's obvious to you now as well. If we look at the card upside down, we can see that what was once 1450 is now OSHI. So Oshi. So I think we're gonna, I guess, pull on the Oshi book, see if anything happens, and if not, then I'm gonna take the book out and have a look into it. Yes, that was the right book. Good. Das Buch ist ein geheimer Schalter. Das Bücherregal gleitet zur Seite und enthüllt ein Kartenlesegerät. Steckt die Zugangskarte mit der angegebenen Orientierung des Pfeils hinein. The book is a secret switch. The bookcase glides to the side and reveals a card reader. Put in the entrance card with the arrows in the marked orientation. So we don't have an entrance card yet. Let's have a look at the other things that we discovered. So when we opened the cupboard or the locker, we found this im Schrank. An der Innenseite der Schranktür findet ihr einen Teil des Alphabets, ein paar weiße Kittel und ein verschlüsseltes Wort. Entschlüsselt das Wort, um fortzufahren. Inside the locker. On the inside of the locker door, you find a piece of the alphabet. A pair of white, things that doctors wear. coats, white coats, and a encoded word, which reads VRMHGVRM. So, here we only have half the alphabet, but in the desk drawer we find the rest of the alphabet. So I think we have to combine these. But how? Because if you look closely, both of them have arrows on the left side, as if to say, connect them here. Maybe that's just how I would interpret that. So can we actually get something meaningful out of connecting them that way? Let's have a look. V would be the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th from the bottom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I. R would be the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th from the top. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And E. I, E. That, yeah, that is a possibility in German to have this combination of letters at the beginning of a word, but I'm not sure if that's the right combination. Let's move on and see if it's gonna make any more sense. The last one, A-Z, I-E-Z? No, I don't think that's gonna be a real word, neither in English nor in German. So maybe it's gotta be like this. You know, arrows to arrows. Maybe that's the way to go. Maybe rather like this then. Let's have a look. First letter V was the 5th from the bottom, and E. And second R was the 5th from the top, so I. E-I. That could be something in German. Let's see how that continues. V-R-M. M is the top one, and the top one is an N, so E-I-N, which spells ein, N in English. But let's see what comes after that. H. H is the 8 from the bottom, or maybe rather from the top. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6th from the top. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6th. It's an S. Eins, okay. G is the 7th from the bottom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. T, einst, oder einst. V is 5th from the bottom. E, einste. Oh yeah, I get it. R is 5th. E, so I, and M is N again. So it spells Einstein or Einstein, if you want to pronounce it in English. So like the famous inventor, or physician rather, Albert Einstein. Which is, of course, fitting because we are in the lab of a potentially slightly mad scientist. did that correctly. So we had to turn around one of the papers so that the arrows lined up and then combine the letters from both sides. So, good job, us. So now we can put those two aside. In the drawer of the desk, we find beneath the piece of paper ziemlich viele Kapseln. In der Schublade sind auch einige Kapseln, aber nur eine lenkt eure Aufmerksamkeit auf sich. Welche ist die besondere Kapsel? So in this drawer we find lots of capsules, I think would be the word. In the drawer are also some capsules, but only one is catching our attention, which is the special one. So let's have a look. They're pretty small. So I hope you can see them, and I'm gonna have to look up a bit to see them as well. It seems they all have one blue end and one white end, and a blue and a red and a black stripe in the middle. So I guess the order is gonna be different on one of them. Seems that most of them, or all of them, have white, black, red, blue. So I'm looking for one that has white, red, black, blue. But I am either blind, or I'm looking for the wrong thing. Both is possible, of course. White, red, no. White, black. Oh, here. Yes, I am blind. I hope you can see that. Right there, we have a capsule with white, red, black, blue. Instead of white, black, red, blue. So, I think we should pick this one up and open it. Maybe not taste it. And we are correct. So, I guess we're gonna open it in the next step. Die besondere Kapsel. Gut gemacht. Ihr habt die besondere Kapsel gefunden. Aber kann sie für euch wirklich nützlich sein? Bevor ihr nicht wisst, was sie bewirkt, solltet ihr sie lieber nicht einnehmen. So, well done. You have found the special capsule. But can it really be useful to you? Before you don't know what it will do, you should maybe not take it or ingest it. Turn this card around and look at the capsule. Keep it, it could be useful. Well, it's just the bigger picture of the capsule again. But we're gonna keep it as demanded. So, let's have a look. We haven't looked at the green one yet. Der doppelte Boden. Sobald ihr Einstein sagt, antwortet die Roboterstimme. Guten Morgen, Doktor. Und ein automatischer Mechanismus öffnet den doppelten Boden des Schranks. Er ist voll mit altmodischer Kleidung und Gegenständen. Ein ziemlich moderner Gegenstand lenkt eure Aufmerksamkeit auf sich. As soon as you say, Einstein, the robot voice answers, Good morning, Doctor. And an automatic mechanism opens the double floor of the locker. It is full of object is catching your attention. Turn this card around and look at the entrance card. Keep it, it could be useful. So, it seems we found the entrance card that we need for our card reader. But we're not gonna put the card into the reader just yet. We're gonna do that in the next video. I hope you had fun. I hope I didn't drive you mad by not seeing the clues fast enough. And I hope you will be back for the next video. My name is Leander. And until next time, make the best of it.